Thank you. That concludes the debate on Scotland's population, meeting the needs of our communities, economy and public services. It's now time to move on to the next item of business, which is an urgent question. And I call Graeme Simpson.
Thank you. To ask the Scottish Government what its response is to the claim in a BBC report today that the process for awarding the contract for ferries 801 and 802 may have been rigged.
Cabinet Secretary John Swinney.
President Officer, these allegations by the BBC were first put to me in advance of an interview I conducted last week as part of the programme to be broadcast this evening. Scottish Ministers are not aware of any impropriety in the procurement process, but take the claims made extremely seriously, and it is important that they are carefully addressed. As I made clear in my interview, these issues are concerning. I know that the current management team at CMAL and at Ferguson's share that concern. I have committed already that Ministers would explore what further steps the Government needs to take to ensure that all questions about the fairness and appropriateness of the tendering process are properly independently investigated. I can confirm that the Permanent Secretary, at the request of Ministers, has already proactively been in contact with the Auditor-General to discuss this matter. The Auditor-General informed the Permanent Secretary that Audit Scotland will be looking at the substance of the allegations raised around procurement by the programme before deciding if further audit work is required. I welcome this. Scottish Government, CMAL and Ferguson's all commit to fully supporting that exercise.
Graeme Simpson.
Can I thank the Deputy First Minister for that answer? We found out today that the disastrous ferries contract does appear to have been rigged in Ferguson's favour. The new documents appear to show that Ferguson's received a 424-page report to help their bid. Nobody else did. Ferguson's was allowed to change its design at the halfway mark. Nobody else was. Ferguson's was able to change its price after the deadline. Nobody else could. Ferguson's received a confidential in-person meeting. Nobody else got that. In short, it appears Ferguson's received special treatment from this government and its agencies. Special treatment that nobody else got. Special treatment that might have broken laws, which could open the government to legal action. This is a scandal. It looks like corporate corruption. And the fact we're only finding out now means it's been a cover-up as well. So can the Deputy First Minister tell us this? Who chose to give Ferguson special treatment? And why were the documents, which we now know about, kept hidden?
Cabinet Secretary.
As I've indicated in my earlier answer, there is a lot of material in the BBC report which was first put to ministers last week and to which I've responded in an interview in good faith. And I've indicated that there are issues of concern that require to be explored. And I welcome the comments made by the Auditor-General this afternoon that he is to consider what further audit work is required in the light of the points raised by the BBC report. There are issues of concern because I do not believe it would be appropriate for the level of specific information that the BBC documentary believes was available to Ferguson's to have been available to them. But it is important that I place on the parliamentary record that CMAL have made clear to the BBC that they can find no trace of that document going from CMAL to Ferguson's. And it's important that these points of factual accuracy are put on the record. In relation to the wider questions that are raised, that is why I gave the commitment that these new points of detail and information that have been raised by the BBC documentary need to be explored further, and I welcome what the Auditor-General has said in that respect today.
Yeah. Graeme Simpson.
It is no use the Deputy First Minister hiding behind the Auditor-General. Yeah. Yeah. These claims were put to him last week. I cannot believe that he has just been sitting there doing nothing, not finding out what has gone on. So if the government accepts this is wrong, and they appear to do that, but they don't know how it's happened or who's responsible, then surely they must now call in the police to investigate. Because if Ferguson receives special treatment for whatever reason, it's beyond the scandal. It's a crime, in my view. This alleged rigging of the contract, this potential fraud, has cost the country £250 million, and it's rising. So will the government now call in the police so we can finally find out the truth of what has happened?
Cabinet Secretary.
Mr. Simpson asks what I've been doing since these points were put to me, and what I've been doing is asking the Permanent Secretary of the Scottish Government to raise with Audit Scotland the issues that have been put to us to enable Audit Scotland to consider, who of course have undertaken audit work already in relation to the Ferguson's procurement process, to establish any further inquiry that is required to be undertaken. And of course, what that would enable is independent scrutiny of the procurement process to be undertaken, as Audit Scotland do on countless other issues and have done on the Ferguson's contract already. So that is what I've been doing, because I thought Parliament would want there to be a process of independent assessment of these issues which can be properly considered, and any appropriate action taken as a consequence.
Alistair Allen.
The reports from the BBC today regarding historic allegations of potential impropriety between CMAL and Ferguson's during the procurement process are clearly concerning. Can the Deputy First Minister provide assurances about the timescale involved in the full investigation of this matter?
Cabinet Secretary.
Well, obviously, we don't want matters of this nature taking an inordinate amount of time to be investigated. If there are concerns raised, they should be properly looked into. That is the steps that the Permanent Secretary has taken on Ministers' behalf in raising this issue with Audit Scotland. I welcome, as I say, what the Auditor General has said this afternoon to enable us to undertake, or for there to be, independent investigation of the claims that have been made to determine what further action is required to be taken.
Rhoda Grant.
Thank you, Presiding Officer, and what is being trailed by the BBC is very worrying, as is the Deputy First Minister's answer about being unable to find any exchange of documents. The Auditor General struggled to investigate this procurement process previously. So can I ask, what changes has he made, and what information will he make available to allow the Auditor General to investigate thoroughly? And in the interests of full transparency, will he now agree to an independent public inquiry into the whole fiasco, and indeed to call in the police if corruption is suspected?
Absolutely. Cabinet Secretary.
In relation to the point that Rhoda Grant puts to me in connection with any further investigation, I've set out to Parliament the steps that we've taken to enable there to be, to raise with Audit Scotland the issues that have been put to us, and Audit Scotland have made their own judgment, as they should do as the independent auditing body within Scotland. In relation to documentation, I would remind Rhoda Grant that the government published a huge volume of material in December 2019, if my memory serves me correctly, which went through all of the detail around the information that was available on the procurement process and the development of the contract with Ferguson's. And as I've indicated in my answer today, the Scottish Government, CMAL and Ferguson's all commit to fully supporting any investigation that is properly undertaken under the auspices of the Auditor General.
Liam MacArthur.
Thank you. Can I very much share the concerns expressed by Graeme Simpson, Alistair Allen and Rhoda Grant? We were told by ministers that everything was out in the open, that the government had nothing to hide. So why is it we are only finding out about this now, and what does it say about the oversight function within this Scottish government?
Cabinet Secretary.
Set out in my answer to Rhoda Grant, the government published a huge volume of material in 2019 which covered all aspects of the procurement process. Now, obviously, there are specific points being raised with us about the Ferguson's, about information to which Ferguson's had access, which was information that ministers did not previously know was the case. So that is why we've taken the steps we've taken in raising these issues with Audit Scotland today, to enable Audit Scotland to be able to make a judgment about the issues that are raised in the BBC documentary. And the government wants to make sure that any question that is raised in this respect is properly and fully considered as part of the analysis that should properly be undertaken in the awarding of a contract if concerns of this type are raised.
Thank you. That concludes the urgent question. And there are three questions to be put as a result. Point of order, Douglas Ross.
Thank you very much, Presiding Officer. I wonder if you could outline to those of us who represent Moray and the Highlands how we could encourage the Scottish Government to provide a statement or hopefully a full debate on the future of maternity services in Moray. You will be aware, Presiding Officer, that SNP members are saying to raise it.
Thank you. Sorry. Thank you, members. We will hear Mr. Ross.
I'm sorry. We have the public health minister laughing that this is not a point of order. I really hope she comes back with more than laughter, because no one in Moray and no one in the Highlands and Islands is laughing about this issue.
Mr. Ross. I am sure that all members of this Parliament are firmly committed to the idea that all voices are heard in this chamber. But what I would prefer is to hear one voice at a time. And if we could hear Mr. Ross, thank you.
I'm very grateful, Presiding Officer, because you will be aware that the Scottish Conservatives proposed at the Bureau this morning that the Scottish Government do dedicate time this week to debate this issue. This follows an amendment to the business I tried to make on the 28th of June this year, because we know that NHS Grampian announced their plans for Model 4 on the 1st of July. At the time, the Business Minister, Mr. Adam, assured us that there would be opportunities for this Parliament to debate and scrutinise plans for Model 4. And indeed, the Health Secretary said to the BBC at the time, "I intend updating the Scottish Parliament as soon as is practical at the beginning of the next session." We are now just a couple of weeks away from the end of this session, and the Scottish Government confirmed this morning that they would not include time this week to discuss this issue. It continues to cause great concern for mothers-to-be and families in Moray. Yeah. But today, NHS Highland looked at the proposal to transfer more Moray women through to Raigmore and to give birth in Inverness. And Keep Mum, the group who have campaigned so hard for the restoration of maternity services in Moray today, called that meeting tone deaf. They said what they heard at the meeting of NHS Highland does not encourage them that anything is going to happen anytime soon. So can you advise us, Presiding Officer, how we can get some statements, some answers, some response from the Scottish Government on this issue? Because please remember, to the SNP members who don't want this to be debated, We were promised over 4 years ago that the downgrading of maternity services in Moray would be temporary for a year. It is now more than 4 years later. We need answers, we need a response, we need to hear from the SNP Scottish Government what they are going to do to ensure that we can get maternity services back at Dr Gray's to deliver for the women and families of Moray.
Thank you, Mr Ross, and for advance notice. It is the case that whether a ministerial statement is to be proposed is a matter for the Scottish Government rather than a point of order for me to rule on. However, your comments are now on the record. I am minded at this point. There are three questions to be put as a result of today's business, but I'm minded to accept a motion without notice under Rule 11.2.4 of Standing Orders to bring decision time forward to now. Thank you, Minister. The question is that decision time be brought forward to now. Are we all agreed?
Yes.
We are agreed. The first question is that Amendment 6063.3, in the name of Donald Cameron, which seeks to amend motion 6063 in the name of Angus Robertson on Scotland's population meeting the needs of our communities, economy and public services be agreed. Are we all agreed?
No.
The Parliament is not agreed, therefore we'll move to a vote and there'll be a short suspension to allow members to access the digital voting system.